398.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you alone can bring into order the unruly wills and affection of sinners. Grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise, that among the swift and varied changes of the world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
Remember the former things, or consider the things of old. I am about to do a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The wild animals will honor me, the jackals and the ostriches, for I give water in the wilderness, rivers in the desert to give drink to my chosen people. People whom I formed for myself, so that they might declare my praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed is inserted in the bulletin for today, Psalm 126, will be said responsibly by whole verse. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then were we like those who dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy.
Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the watercourses of the Negev.
Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. It doesn't say.
Yes.
Eight. I too have reason for confidence in the flesh. If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew born of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, a persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless. Yet whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but one that comes through faith in Christ, the righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection, and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained this or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sequence is in 441, verses 1 through 4.
Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume made of pure nard, anointing Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Probably a little bit of an explanation before the sermon. I know it seems a little bit confusing today, and it is a little bit confusing. The reader was supposed to be Doc Simmons, and of course the parish administrator took his name out because he's still in the hospital. He's still in the telemetry unit, and making very, very little and very slow progress. So we too continue to keep him in our prayers. So that was the reading confusion. Nobody was prepared because Doc was supposed to be here, and Doc was always here. So there we are. But now, getting to the topic of the day on this Passion Sunday is that story, that wonderful story that is about Mary. It's found in all four Gospels. They don't always agree about it. They get a little bit confused on it. Well, maybe confused. They can't agree which Mary, what day of the week, you know, those kind of things. But they all tell the same story, because all those things are sort of like not the important details. And it's easy to get sort of waylaid by the details that don't mean anything and miss the point. So we're going to hear and remember that story. Origen, one of our ancestors in faith, one of the early church fathers, writes about today's lesson, and he says, "So powerful is the praise of a good work of this kind that it exhorts all of us to fill the Lord's head with fragrant and rich works, so that it may be said of us as well that we have done good work for Christ's head." Jesus says at the end of the gospel that the woman's, Mary's, act will be remembered forever. Origen's words are wonderful, but he goes on. And when he goes on, he sort of falls into the trap. Falls into the trap. Have you ever known somebody, and I think of politicians a lot, you know, when they don't like the way things are going or the direction of things going, they sort of distract us, right? They say, "No, look over here. Don't look here, look over there." So, you know, and they go from A to E, and we follow. We go from A to E, and then we get to E, and we say, "What happened to A? And how do we get back to A?" Well, Origen sort of goes down that road. And it's a road that's been prepared for him in the gospel by the words that are attributed to Judas. That could have been sold than the money given to the poor. And then we don't need to go into why John says that. So, but it's easy to go down that distraction. Judas does it. And then many of our ancestors of faith do the same thing. Oh, yeah! And it's easy to do because in Lent we think about almsgiving and how important it is to be a good giver of alms as a response to God. But Judas did it as a distraction. Judas is giving a distraction because he doesn't like what's happening. So often we fall in the same trap and get distracted. We get distracted by the really good news of this story. The amazing news of the story. And that how we too can be people whose deeds are remembered. Maybe not throughout all time, but those who witness them. The story is only, in a small sense, about alms. This is an amazing story. I love this story because I want you to think. Put on your hat. I'm not always good on that because we're not good at memorizing scripture verses, but hopefully we remember the stories. Can you think of another time in the gospel accounts and the infancy narratives don't really care? You know, we can't say the innkeeper or the wise men because Jesus is a baby. It doesn't really matter. That's not in Jesus' ministry. Another time where someone cares for Jesus without wanting something from him. I want to go back and just check. I think this is the only time someone cares for Jesus not because they want something. The disciples have been walking with Jesus for 3 years. They sat at his feet. They've taken knowledge from him, and when they don't like what he says, they ignore it. The disciples have witnessed miracles. People have come to him wanting to feel justified, wanting to be healed, wanting to hear good news, but always wanting something from him. We are in the Gospel of John just before Jesus heads down the Mount of Olives into the Holy City. That day before, Jesus has been telling the disciples several times what's going to happen. And his mind is set to go to Jerusalem. And he comes to a familiar home with familiar friends and the disciples for a quiet meal. And Mary senses his countenance. There's something weighing on Jesus. You never think about things weighing on the heart of God. He's not the same in a sense. Where is that Jesus I knew the last time he was here? It just doesn't seem right. Have you ever had that? Where you know something's just not right. I don't know what it is, but something's just not right. So often in life, we encounter kind of people that are strong. Think of that. People that you know that are strong. Say, Nothing's going to get them down. Turmoils may come, but they always rise above it. They'll get through. Everything will be all right. You know, it's just a passing thing. And we count on that. We depend on that. We depend on them to get through in their own strength, in their own ability. And Jesus gets through this on his own ability, in a sense. But even when the disciples see Jesus crying in the garden, they can't stay awake. They can't be concerned enough to stay awake. But this Mary senses something about Jesus. And she gives the best of what she has to care for him. Not because she wants something, but simply because she loves him and cares for him. That's why the story is still told. That's the good news that we can take from it. Not that we need to be worried about how we use our money. There are other times to remember that. But to remember that God asks us to learn from this lesson, to be attentive to one another, to when things are just not right, and not to be afraid to step in. Not even say, what's wrong? But just to step in. Whether they're hungry, sad, depressed, you don't know what it is. Those quiet, simple moments where we discern in one another as Mary discerned in Christ. And we step forward, offering our best gift in that moment. When Jesus will remember that story, that event forever, and we remember that story now. It is in those small, discerning moments when we just step in that we can help to transform others' lives by sharing the simplest gifts of a looking and longing heart. So, don't be concerned about what could have been done with the ointment, other than using it. Because you see, even your Lord and Master in a moment need anxiety and sorrow. That's good news. That we can be observant people and transform lives. Not in grand gestures, always, but in simple concern. Let us pray that we may learn from Mary's example and open our eyes to see Christ in our midst. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven
silence.
Give us strength and hear our prayer.
Give your church the courage to give up her preoccupation with herself and to give more time to your mission in the world.
We pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our primate, William, our diocesan bishop, Joe Morris, our retired bishop, our companion diocese of Ecuador Central and Ecuador Litoral, for the province of Jerusalem and the Middle East, and for the clergy and people in the diocese on the Anglican cycle of prayer this week. In our diocese, we pray for Trinity Cathedral, for those in the vocational process, for clergy celebrating ordination anniversaries, and for the Bishop Search and Nomination Committee.
May the blood and water flowing from the side of Jesus bring forgiveness to your people and help us to face the cost of proclaiming salvation. Lord, meet us in the silence.
Give us strength and hear our prayer.
Give your world the courage to give up war, bitterness, and hatred, and to seek peace.
We pray for our nation, for Joseph, our president, Kamala, our vice president, members of Congress and the judiciary, for Philip, our governor, and all elected officials, for those leaders of nations, for the leaders of all nations, and those working for peace and nuclear disarmament.
May the shoulders of the risen Jesus, once scourged by soldiers, bear the burden of political and military conflict in our world. Lord, meet us in the silence.
Give us strength and hear our prayer.
Give us the courage to give up quarrels, strife, and jealousy in our families, neighborhoods, and communities.
We pray for the people and leadership of Ukraine and for those working to meet their needs, for the safety and well-being of all men and women serving in the armed forces and for their loved ones, for all refugees and immigrants, and for all victims of racism, starvation, and terrorist attacks, for all medical workers, first responders, medical researchers, and all other essential workers, for an awareness of sustaining the environment, our society, and the economy, and for the outreach ministries of the parish, especially those we serve through Gleanings, the Allentown Food Pantry, the Poor Box Ministry, and the ingathering of socks and items for Ukraine.
May the presence of the risen Jesus, his body once broken and now made whole, bring peace and direction as we live with one another. Lord, meet us in the silence.
Give us strength and hear our prayer.
Give us the courage to give up our selfishness as we live for others and to give time, care, and comfort to the sick.
We pray for those who are ill in body, mind, or spirit, especially Jason, Vincent, Tracy, Joshua, Tim Kahn, Andrew, Brad, Diane, Dave, Gigi, Joe, Lisa, Laurel, Heaven, Robin, Joy, Michelle, Diane, Ella Childs, Carl, Rochelle. We pray for holy death and peace at the last for Albert, for those on the hearts and minds of our Gleanings guests, for those who live with prolonged illnesses, for those preparing for and recovering from surgery, for those who are with child, and for all those who mourn and grieve.
May the wounded hands of Jesus bring us healing touch and the light of his presence fill their rooms. Lord, meet us in the silence.
Give us strength and hear our prayer.
Give us the courage to give up our fear of death and to rejoice with those who have died in faith.
Especially we hold in our minds Flora Cormier. The sanctuary candle burns in honor of the Lord's presence in the Blessed Sacrament and in loving memory of Norman T. Pete and Elsa P. Pownell.
May the feet of the risen Lord Jesus, once nailed to the cross, walk alongside the dying and bereaved in their agony, and walk with us and all your church through death to the gate of glory.
And we pray for those celebrating birthdays this week: Rebecca Clark, Judy Kelly, Lily Anna Monclova, Christine Burns, Elijah Christian Burns.
Lord, meet us in the silence.
Give us your strength, hear our prayer, hear in the eternity. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated and go to the announcements. Please do note that next week is Palm Passion Sunday. So for the 9:30 service, we begin in the labyrinth for the blessing of palms and the procession into the church. So just, it's supposed to be nice, but you may want to make sure you wear comfortable shoes. So that is next week. Passion narratives were distributed for the 9:30 service because we've used the longer passion. We still have a couple of vacancies to fill with the reading, so I know we get so busy after church often that we don't get around to signing, but there are like three lines left, so we need like two persons. One person can do two lines, but we have three lines to get covered, so we could use two more readers. And remember, you should do it where you're standing. You don't have to get up and move around. It's very simple, but that is next week. So please do speak to one of the clergy afterward, and we'll make sure we get the passion narrative for next week. Please do note that Easter flower offerings, that was in the last mailing envelope for that. It is our tradition to post last year's list on the door by the White Coffee Hour station, and what is normally the Coffee Hour station. And it has been posted, so you can check last year's list. If you don't know what you did with your Easter flower envelope, there are copies on the book table in the narthex today. Of course, Wednesday Eucharist will be held this week. Thursday, there's the 7 o'clock service. And then on Friday at 7:30 p.m., Stations of the Cross will be offered here in the church. We are gathering plants for the Garden of Repose, which again this year will still be set up here in the church rather than in the narthex, which is our tradition. But we're still making our way out of COVID restrictions. So, you'll be really pleased, hopefully, that we're going to sing some service music next week. So we'll feel even a little more like we're heading down that road. Please do remember Easter Day. We are going back to receptions. There will be reception on Easter Day, so we ask you to bring something to share for that. It will be outside. We will get a couple of tents just to cover the food, but we'll be basically having the Easter reception in the Memorial Garden and Labyrinth area on Easter Day. And then the coffee hour sign-up sheet is out on the white counter for the Sundays for the remainder of the spring after that. So there we move. And if the guys want to work on Mother's Day, you better speak up. Let me know what we're doing. What do we have? We have a tentative coffee hour person who will be glad to forego it if the men are doing something again this year. But we've had a couple of years off from that, so we're sort of just making our way back still. We thank you for your continual gifts to our help for the Ukraine. Lynn was just there at St. George's, straight down the street, sorting yesterday. They're not taking clothes at the moment. They're taking, of course, cash. They've got a really great deal right now with whoever. Most agencies are paying $1 a pound to ship. They've got a 50 cents a pound, so they want to sort of like ship stuff off while they still got the cheap rate, which they can. So they are still taking cash and items, especially on medical supplies, first aid kits, that kind of, or bandages, that kind of thing. So just remember, just bring those items in. The need will be gone one. They will probably take clothes and stuff in a little while, but they just shipped off a bunch of stuff, and so they're really focusing on other items at this point. So there we are. That's that one. I must have forgotten something, but I can't remember what.
I don't know what you forgot. But I do have a request. Based on Canon Art's sermon, there is a way that we can all be present somebody who hasn't been here for a while, and that's Doc. Doc doesn't have any family in the area. He has a friend who lives in North Jersey, and he has two friends who live in Virginia. But realistically, in this area, we are his family. So, two things you can do. For anybody who is willing to go into the hospital for a brief time to visit him, you are able to go into Robert Wood Johnson Hospital. You can talk to Ken and Art or myself. There's a little procedure you have to go through, but it doesn't really take that long. But the big thing is, anybody can write a card. You know, he's very, very grateful for our visits, and we always tell him people are praying. He's grateful for all the prayers coming from Holy Apostles. However, his room is pretty bare. You know, there doesn't seem, we did bring cards a few weeks ago, but he was in ICU. I don't know what happened with those cards, but you know, cards, get well cards, thinking of you cards. Easter's coming up. I think he would be very grateful. You could just bring him here to the church. I think that would be best. If he ever gets out of the hospital or sent to a care facility, I would have that address, and I could send it there or send it to his friend.
Okay. Offer to God the sacrifice of thanksgiving and make the bed thousands for the Most High. Presentation hymn is hymn 609.
Oh,
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right, and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You bid your faithful people cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that, fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, and with him, and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is to his almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen."
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Grant mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world, the gift of God for the people of God. Body of Christ. Let us stand and sing hymn 382. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of our heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Look with compassion, O Lord, upon this, your people, that rightly observing this holy season, they may learn to know you more fully and to serve you with a more perfect will. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.